Well, I'm a family man, in spite of my public image. I don't play with my family life. I'm what I am today because of the love and support I've enjoyed from the family institution. Even my role in politics, I must say, was influenced by my father and mother, who made their home an open house where people could come with their problems, no matter the time of day, and something would be done to solve it. So I became interested in people at a very early age. And I grew up in a family where, even though it was supposed to be a polygamous setting, we were so closely knit. I got to hear the word half-brother for the first time in secondary school, and I was shocked when somebody referred to one of my brothers, my half-brother. And I said, no, I don't have a half-brother. My brothers are complete. We are full, I have full brother, not half. You know, and he told me, no, what he meant was that since we are not the same mother, it meant that it was my half-brother. I said, no, I don't accept that. In my house, we are the same brothers and the same sisters. We eat from the same pot. We sleep together. We do everything together. So I must thank my father, my mother, for the kind of upbringing that I got, where we support each other. You know, we celebrate when we have to celebrate. We cry when we have to cry. You know, we're very supportive. And when I wanted to marry, I was already in my early 30s when I got married. I was a bit worried about who I would have as a life partner. I knew that there was a lot of difference between having a girlfriend and having a wife. And eventually she said yes, and we got married. And I must say that that decision is the best thing that happened to me in life. I also say this, coincidentally, my wife and I, we share the same birthday. You know, she was born June 21st. I'm also born June 21st. But she's been a pillar. She's been my counselor. She's been my prayer partner. She's been very supportive. She's also given me 3 girls and a boy. I look forward coming home every day. And I enjoy every time I spend with my family. Well, because of my public engagements, I try to spend quality time with my wife and with my children when I'm home. Most of the time, I try to engage them. I realize from interacting with so many people that one of the greatest problems in many homes is the lack of communication between husband and wife and between parents and children. And so because of that, I spend time to talk with my wife. I try to summarize my own activities, and I give her the opportunity to also tell me her experiences in her place of work. And one good thing about my wife is that in spite of all her qualifications, she still enjoys going to cook for her husband. No matter the number of people that I have, she wants to cook for them. So though we have a cook, she likes to go there, cook herself, see what is happening. So I also appreciate that. You know, sometimes too, I also want to exercise myself. There was a time in the past when I used to swim, and I still have a big swimming pool which I keep clean. I used to also walk around. Before, it was jogging around, but later I realized that as you go older, it's better to walk than to jog. I'm also a very good draft player. You know, people look at draft and they think that it's for people who didn't go to school. But that's not true. It's one of the most mentally stimulating or challenging exercises. Draft is like playing chess, but chess has more, maybe the supporters, maybe, yes, you know. But in Nigeria, people think that draft is a game that is played for people who didn't go to school. That's not true. I've come across a lot of doctors, engineers, lawyers who also play draft. And I'm quite honestly one of the best around. And I organize draft competitions from time to time. Not too long ago, I organized a competition for Nigeria Ghana and Cameroon, you know, and it was nice bringing all the champions from these three countries to come and play. What we don't know is that they actually even organize drag competitions worldwide. They do drag competitions all over the world. So that Nigeria is still not being given necessary encouragement. And I've been trying to see how I can help them set up a drag federation. I'm discussing it with the ministry, and I hope that very soon they would have a federation and they'll be able to compete at the highest level. But there are so many people who know how to play that game well, but because they've not been able to get the required encouragement, they are not playing at the level they should be playing it. So I also spend time with them. I call them. Many times they come to my house to organize competitions. I watch them play, and I enjoy watching them or just playing. So those are the small things I do to while away my time.